Nice.
Yeah. Yo, that's Gucci. So we are in March now. February was bearish as hell. Damn. So near the end of the month, we got some major sell-off. So I'm going to go over the NAS and the S&P, just the overall market futures, just before we get into this week's ticker breakdown. So I really like our chances of this being the bottom, but I don't want to just be closed-minded to the fact that this could be the start of a bear market. So what I'd be looking to basically solidify that a bear market is in is if we reject this 8 EMA coming up here, because on the way up it's used as support, but when the market turns around, we're going to see is if this 8 EMA acts as resistance, then we're going to know, all right, damn, we might be having some further downside coming in the future. It might overshoot, retest this trend line up here, and then get shot down again. Right now we have this area here as a kind of like a major supply zone right now. So if we get stuffed in this area, that would not be very good for us bulls. So we'll run the fibs on the move to see what happens. Yeah, that seems to be the area. So this 13,000 zone for the NASDAQ, if this continues to get shot down, just clearly in a bear market, which means you might want to be more hands off when it comes to diving in deep, because prices could end up lower on some of the stocks you're looking at. So when the overall market is consolidating, expect the stocks that are in that specific futures, they're going to consolidate as well, right? So let's check out the SPY. And we're getting a nice bounce this morning. And so we're going to see, is this going to just V-shape towards all-time highs, and then we're going to crack 4K? Like, that would be absolutely ideal, but we will have to see, because these markets have been like, look at this bear volume, right? So usually when you see like big large green volume, it's indicating that there's going to be higher prices. But when you're indicating big large red volume, it could be indicating that there's lower prices coming, which could be fair, right? We had a massive run from the bottom, so we could be seeing just another major area of pulling back before we make that next leg up, which would be completely healthy, to be honest. So it'll be able to give us the opportunity to get the stocks that we like at a cheaper price. So pay attention to the stocks that you like. Make sure you like mark down some like areas or some zones that you think it might pull back to, or some prices that you think are, oh, this stock's like on sale now, I would like to pick it up at that price. Because if it comes, you'll want to be able to pull the trigger without hesitation. So what we want to see and pay attention to is, of course, is it going to reject the 80 EMA now? That's major key to see. If it is getting rejected, then I'd say like careful to, and I'd be just hands off for like buying opportunities. But at the same time, it could be the bottom, which would be right after a nice pullback, right after on the NAS, it was like a 9% pullback. On the S&P, it's only like a 4 or 5% pullback. So to be honest, if this is the bottom and we're getting ready for a nice run, this is going to be a nice time to get the stocks that you've seen at a cheaper price open. So this is the one that lost to NEO for the weekly updates on it. But I really do like this chart, to be honest. So we had a clear resistance point. It broke up, broke down, and then we came up over and tried to make this the new demand zone. And it looks to be like we're getting some buying pressure coming from this zone. We could tell, because if you look at all these wicks coming from the bottom and how many times we get bought up from this $25 range, I'd say buying around this area, having the stop at shortly below it, is a great opportunity. That's a 46% trade to the highs if you catch it somewhere down in this range. Maybe like a 40% trade. That's a nice opportunity. I really like the looks of this chart. Open looks like a great opportunity. Fire. So a fire was one of those ganja stocks, right? Some are going to get a really nice bounce. I really like CGC and Truul, and CBDT was ripping and it got a nice reversal. What else we got here? Growing. I'm starting to like growing too, but to be honest, fire, like I don't really like that one too much. Like I don't really like the chart on fire. Yeah, like if you look, it just keeps getting shot down. It was once worth like $3. Yeah, and then it got shot down, keeps getting shot down. There's a lot of supply, so if you want this one to go big, you might have to wait a long time, right? That, or it might never go big. DNN, Denison Mines Corporation. What do we think of this chart here? I like how it's starting to catch some ground here at this dollar range. If it could hold this dollar range, this could be a nice time to buy and then make its way towards its highs at $1.80. Not a bad looking chart. I have no idea about the company or the fundamentals or anything like that, but the chart doesn't look too bad. It's been uptrending since November 2020. If it can stabilize in this area and create a floor here, I'd expect it to want to make a nice move to $1.80. I also like how the bearish volume is starting to drop off, which is really nice to see. I like DNN, how it's starting to look there. CCIV, so yo, this looks like it could be shaping up real nice. It could also be bear flagging, so there's like two opposite opportunities that could be coming up right here. But like, if this wants to be bullish and it still wants to pick up some steam, there's a gap that it left behind, and when you look at the hourly time frame, it could just curl right back above and end up ripping right through this gap. So that would be actually a really nice trade, an 80% trade, to be honest. So it would look something like this, your risk to reward opportunity, which would be kind of nice. Because if it breaks below this area, then it's not looking so good. Then it would have to fight this to get back over, but it could be shaping up a really nice trade here. Keep CCIV on your watch list just in case for a short-term trade opportunity. QYOU, not sure what this does, but this one's a penny stock. Kind of like how it's holding up this area. I'd want it to hold this. I wouldn't want to see it to continue to break below. I'm not sure how it did on the earnings, but it made a highs of 52 cents. Could be also shaping up a head and shoulders pattern just in case. You got to be careful for that. You never know if it's trying to signal you that, hey, this actually is getting a little bit tired and the trend is changing. So just be aware of that if it comes up here and it just can't break over. Although the opportunity could be there for the bulls to buy off this demand zone and then expect a move to the upside. MVMD, another penny stock. I like this, how it's uptrending though. From 10 cents, made a base. You wanted to make another base up here in this area. A lot of these charts are looking similar because the last few weeks have been probably pretty bearish, which probably had an effect on a lot of these stocks, right? But if it holds this base area and it doesn't want to break down, low volume, I'd expect it's trying to make another leg up, which is what you want to see in the reality of things. Jets, the Jets ETF. So this ETF is the one that has all the airlines in it. It looks bullish right now. Like, this is a really nice chart. A lot of the airlines, we could be seeing the rotation of money coming from out of the technology stocks into the airlines and travel stocks. So I'd be aware of that. Bull flag breaks the bull flag. Now we could just be seeing you're riding the 8 EMA all the way up to this major supply zone, and then we might see a rejection from there. So, man, I like the Jets. Look at the stocks inside the Jets ETF and then choose one of those. I'm currently looking at Air Canada and I like AC a lot. CWRK, currency works. This another chart, right? Like, I'm starting to like this chart, the way it's starting to get bought up from these levels. Buying at this level with this as your stop is like a really low risk, high reward opportunity that could come in your favor, right? That's like almost a 10 to 1 trade. The opportunity's there, man. This market's showing us some good opportunities. If this is the bottom of that major pullback and we're about to go on a run, all these stocks that you're watching that are now pulling back to areas that were once like you thought like you wish you could have bought as, now's your opportunity. Like, hey, you could buy and it could run. So keep those on the watch list. I like the way CWRK is looking. BBI. This one could, ooh, I don't really like this one, to be honest. Very much has a lot of supply. Yeah, yikes. I would stay away from this one. It looks like it just keeps getting reverse split or something. Yeah. It just keeps getting reverse split. There's way too much supply here. I would stay away from this one. That's the weekly breakdown for this week. So cheers, guys.